supporting the theaters, coming out here. This has been an unprecedented year. 7 black playwrights made Broadway. I know that probably will never happen again, but we need to see a lot more than we're seeing. So let's make sure that you all spread the word, and people who are not used to this particular kind of play of these particular people, let everybody know that we're all the same. We're all breathing and loving and laughing. We got anger, we got pathos, we got pain, we got joy, we got jokes. I want to acknowledge in that same vein that we are also celebrating Black Theater Night tonight. Yeah. I wanted to bring out the understudies. We had mentioned them. Dominique, Morisseau.
Because this shit is hard, and sometimes I didn't know if moving him across the country country to come do theater in a play was gonna be worth it. And some days we showed up on this stage like, they shutting us down, ain't they? And they didn't know what was going on, and we would see other shows, like other plants, clothes. One of my own other shows, clothes. I mean, not knowing who's next, that's the time we're making theater in. That's the time these eight, actually, black playwrights ended up coming to Broadway through the play. And we still make art through that play. And we show up because we know we have to. I wanted to say something else. I saw online somebody had written something, and I just was posting about the show. I don't know it personally. But she said she was thinking about the play, and she thought to herself, well, does fight, will fight always have to equal sabotage? And I didn't know her, and I didn't answer her in that, because I didn't know the answer. But I know it tonight, and the answer is not collective fight, no. It does. I stand here on the shoulders of auto workers,
yes,
of the auto industry, of factory workers who built my family, built my city. And I don't know how a theater worker could ever see this play and not see themselves in an auto worker ever again, because this unprecedented closings and don't know what's happening. This has never happened to Broadway, but this has happened to factories all the time. And so I guess I just want to leave you with the UAW workers that I talked to. I remember one of them said to me, they said a lot. They wanted me to let y'all know so many things. I put a lot of it in the play because I what they wanted people to know about the United Auto Workers, the UAW, was that they are not, they don't just fight for auto workers' rights. They don't fight for auto workers only. They fight for human rights, because at the whole of every labor movement is human rights, civil rights. And so the labor movement that we see in our field today that mirrors what is going on in this play is a human rights movement. And I am proud to stand in that movement with people on this stage. And I want to thank this entire cast for showing up and saying yes, for passing the baton back and forward. We know who's going to pass it to next. And everybody just pick up the baton, call each other, call me to keep mom around high. What kind of cast does that? And also made sure that each other was held together in this process, and that Ruben, Santiago-Hudson, held the show.
Tonight's story airs on our social media.
Survive a plague if not theater. So thank you so very much.